Cheers, and welcome to the Nook by the Fire on the Voluntary Virtues Network. You might be saying to yourself, Nook by the Fire? Where is your fire?
We got a candle.
It's right here.
We always have a fire, and it's right there.
Yeah, there's a fire.
And maybe not as big as some of those other people's fires, but...
It's like the Olympic torch. As long as there's a flame, we're good. Yeah. As long as there's a flame, we're good.
And we definitely carried that along.
And this one smells like jasmine.
Yes.
Oh, God damn it.
We had a Nook by the fire. Now it's just the Nook.
Well,
on that note.
So the Olympic
torch. So anyway, issue one. Moving on. I'm drinking Clan Ross by Legacy Brewing Company. Never tried it before. It's a Scotch Ale. 8%. It's pretty good. I think it tastes kind of strong for an 8. It's almost tastes like a barley wine or something. It's pretty harsh. But it does have the nice dark, tarry type taste that I like.
Can you see light through it? Is it opaque?
I can see light
it's
through
got
it.
A, then, well, it's almost perfect. It probably, you know.
It sounds good.
Coffee and beer. Good. If you can see light through it, there may be a problem.
What are you drinking, Mike?
I was drinking Karak by Mission Brewery down in San Diego, their Imperial Red Ale. Very good. Went down real quick with me. About 10.2%. So, yeah. If it snuck up on me, it snuck up on me. In the meantime, I'm drinking Season's Greetings in this cup.
I don't even want to know what that is.
It's Season's Greetings.
Matt,
I'm what you got? I'm drinking something from Ninkasi. I actually didn't look at all the specs. It's very good. I will say that.
It's called Slayer.
Slayer, yes. Okay. Yeah. Steve sold it to me. Or gave it to me, and I'm going to pay him back and all that. But, yeah, it's good stuff.
We'll see.
We'll see. if it's no good. I want my damn money.
And a half or a 10,000 silver.
Ninkasi's usually pretty good.
I like their stuff. I've yet to try something from them that I did not want to drink the whole glass.
I don't know if you knew this, but Ninkasi is Sumerian for the god of beer.
Really?
That would make sense if that part of the world has a god of beer, because that's more or less where beer came from what I understand, is from, you know, the Fertile Crescent, as they call it.
The Greeks had a god of beer, too.
Well, it also makes sense. What was the god of beer called?
I don't remember.
Yeah, I'm like, this is running me into my Jeopardy questions right now. Greek god of beer.
Do you remember that guy's name?
YouTube commenters, please help us
out. Yeah, tell us who the Greek god of beer is.
You guys are always amazing at doing that. Yeah. We don't know something, and it's in the comments section.
Yes, every time we don't know something, somebody's good to point it out.
Don't look back at any proof of that.
It's kind of a libertarian trait of that if you don't know something, they'll find it. They'll find it and tell you. You didn't know this. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know all the answers to everything. My bad.
Also, if you're watching this video, you probably also have the rest of the internet alongside it. So currently, we don't have the internet in front of us. As to not get distracted, because that may have happened before. May or may not have.
What, somebody was on the internet and was wrong and you couldn't go to sleep? Yeah, I've been there.
Still onto the topic.
Yeah. So, due to recent events, it seems that protesting the cops has become a full-time job recently for some people. And we thought we'd talk about the different aspects of protesting. Are they effective? If you're going to go to a protest, what should you expect? I read recently, Nick, I think, had a protest gear list. Okay. Different things that you should bring with you if you're going to do a protest.
Mm-hmm.
Which is probably a good idea. Because, you know, they start throwing tear gas and things like that.
Yeah.
Then you'll be glad you brought something to protect yourself.
Yeah, I, on that similar sort of thing about what to do in a protest, without going too far off of our topic exactly, or maybe elaborating on it, but on a different vein, I think protests are effective, even if sometimes in a very limited extent, but they do always have an effect. Would they be more effective than another form of action if you had some money to do a TV commercial? Well, more people are going to see that, of course, but protests are always effective, even in the most minimal of senses. But,
Well, let me ask you something.
Huh.
Are you talking... what are we talking about when we talk about protests?
I'm meaning...
Like, for instance, there's those guys who are blocking freeways and things like
that. Oh, yeah, okay.
And you have the rioters. That could be seen as protest.
A rioter could,
and
yeah.
Then you have the people standing around with signs, blowhorns.
Oh, well, okay, so if...
Yeah, there's a large...
I understand where you're going with the topic, but I'll disagree to say that two out of three of those could be considered protesters. Those are separate actions. If you're holding a sign and standing in a spot, or maybe walking back and forth holding a sign, which is recommended by some old-timers because they can get you for loitering if you stand in a spot with a sign, so you might want to mosey back and forth a little bit. But if you're breaking people's windows and shops and stuff because you're mad at the cops, hey, guess what? That didn't piss off the cops at all. They don't care. And then didn't help
but
your cause.
But you did piss some other people off.
You pissed off some other people. And you want to know the people you pissed off? You pissed off the very same people in your neighborhood who probably don't like cops either. But now they got to fucking clean up a whole bunch of glass and try to talk to an insurance company to get money for their store that got wrecked. And if I remember correctly, and I'm not anywhere near an genius when it comes to insurance, but a riot is considered an act of God. They call it an act of God, yeah. So it's part of, like, I remember reading that somewhere. It's like insurance,
it's
like
as much an act of God as anything.
You know, an act of God is like, you know, rain, thunderstorms, tornadoes, all that sort of shit. They put riots in there too. So if
sure
you're,
it depends on your coverage.
Probably there's in what insurance company and all that. But a riot can be considered an act of God. So if your store gets thrashed by some of your very own neighbors because they're pissed at the cops and they decide to trash your store, you might be asked out of a whole lot of money. You know, your livelihood. You know, we're not talking about people who are like super rich and they've got a 24-hour fitness or a Shell station or whatever that got smashed. We're talking about people who are, you know, barely scraping by sometimes and their store just got ruined. That didn't help the cause at all. That didn't help to bring society back to being more peaceful and cooperative and not having these people who believe they have authority because of badges. That's not that at all. You wreck somebody's store and that's it. And then what was the other thing you were saying? Like, okay, so...
First of all, I'd like to say, Mike, stop beating around the bush. Tell us how you really
Tell me how you really feel. But, you know, yeah, it's just... Wrecking other people's shit doesn't do anything. Oh, it's the freeways. Why the fuck are you going to block a freeway?
Yeah.
People are just trying to get to work. Now, what I do understand is...
If you're blocking the street from the cops.
Yeah, if the cops are rolling down in fucking APCs down the fucking 15, okay, fine. Try to block the freeway. I understand. But if you're going down in like rush hour traffic and... You think blocking the freeway is going to get people to hate the cops more than the person that is stopping them to get to their job that they're just trying to get to either feed themselves, pay their own bills, or feed their kids too?
Yeah.
And trust me, like, there are jobs where you could tell them 2 days in a row, hey, these protesters stopped me in the freeway and I couldn't get here. And they'll look at you straight in the eye and be like, you didn't get here 2 days in a row. You're late tomorrow. You're not having a job. There are places that will tell you that dead in the eye. So, yeah, there's a chance that, you know, some of these protests, if you're stopping the freeway, you might be really fucking somebody's life up. You got to think about that. Go for the source. You want to protest? Go to the cop shop. Stand outside the cop shop. Get a couple thousand people to stand outside the cop shop. You know? Yeah, I'm not saying do anything violent. I'm saying show up there so the cops know, like, that many people out there, at least that many people who showed up, do not like what they're doing.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. It's not effective to go and... I mean, it's all about who are you trying to inform and what message are you trying to get across, because that's the point of a protest normally, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, how would you say that it applied to the checkpoint protests we do?
So you're trying to inform people. I mean, that one was very, you know, informational, because you're standing out there and letting everybody know where the checkpoint is. So they're going to know, hey, don't go that way because there's a bunch of thugs with guns and badges that are going to give you a hard time and at least inconvenience you, at the very least. And it, both the cops and the people being affected both saw the signs.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I'd say you want both sides to see the message, and I think when you're doing a protest, you basically want to get your information out peacefully, number one, and to everybody, both sides. You want it to be a conversation had among a lot of people, and, you know.
In front of the cop shop. In front of the cop shop.
If
I can only keep going to that, but I'm saying, if you're protesting something, you go to the source, you know?
I'd like to see...
It's like the Occupy Wall Street protests.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why are you crapping up a park when you could be crapping up banks?
And there's plenty of banks down there. That's the whole fucking south end of that thing.
It was such a great idea. Who was it that came up with the idea of... The idea is that you have every one of those protesters go into the bank and fill out paperwork for a $1 billion loan.
Doug Stanhope.
Yes, Doug Stanhope. That's right. Yes. And they have to go through the process with you.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not making any money doing it.
Yeah.
Right.
Or, if we're talking about banks, not to get too off topic.
You're obviously not going to get the loan. But
yeah.
You do tie up their time for like an hour.
Banks aren't
going
to give me $1 billion?
For no reason?
I don't know.
I know, messed up, right?
You don't have the right connections or something.
Oh,
I don't know.
Bastards.
But, you know, not to go off too off topic, but I guess I can relate it to it. Here's another form of protest. Close your bank account. Close your bank account. And people go like, oh, I've had, you know, not a whole lot of conversation, but I have a couple people tell me like, oh, well, you know, what's something that I could do? Because maybe I don't like to do protests, or I'm a shut-in. I don't like to really do that sort of stuff. Close your bank account. I'll say it a third time. Close your bank account. Is it really that hard to pay for shit with a money order? Is it really hard to drive somewhere and pay your bill in person? Is it really that bad? As opposed to having everything tied into the system to where, like, all the money you have in there, think about it, they're lending it out tenfold to continue the fucking bombing of people halfway across the world for no goddamn reason, because there's a war on terrorism, or just some people out there we call terrorists and drone their kids. Like, that's where your money's going.
By we, you mean not us.
Yeah, yeah. We're not talking about anybody on here,
that,
like, specifically, you know.
The state.
But, yeah, it's... Yeah, we not, you
gotta
know...
be careful of those
we's, man.
Yeah, I am not the United States of America, nor is anybody else in this room.
I hate being included when it comes to U.S. government action, state action. Nah, that wasn't me, man.
Should we be really nitpicky about it and say that there's the United States and the United States of America? One of them is a corporation, the other one's a country? Dun, dun, dun.
Yes.
No, let's not. That's a whole other podcast, but...
Yeah,
I don't think
it really matters.
Yeah,
it's all
it
a state anyway. It's,
yeah.
Yeah, the semantics of it. Just like trying to play semantics with their laws.
Legal mumbo-jumbo.
Yeah.
So, protest outside of the cop shop, or, ooh, here's a fun one. Go mosey on and talk to the feds. Go stand outside your nearest federal building with some friends and some signs and be like, hey guys, so we're really pissed off, and since the local authorities aren't doing anything about it, how about you guys? Isn't that how, you know, call their bluff. Hey, isn't this how the system's supposed to work? The locals aren't taking care of the problem. The state's not taking care of the problem. We're standing outside the federal building. Hey, guys, why aren't you taking care of it? You know, like, if you don't want to go to the cop shop, try that angle. I don't know. Just whatever you do, don't do anything violent, because you do anything violent, they turn Gestapo on a dime. Do not even think about doing anything violent.
The state is definitely much better at violence than you are.
Yes, they know what you're...
They've had some more practice.
Yeah, they have sonic waves that will put you on the ground. Keep that in mind. Like, if it gets real, they'll walk out with a... They'll pull out a truck out there that has a little dish on it that will put sonic waves into your body and put you in pain on the ground. Think about that before you be like, oh, well, maybe we can break some windows and really
prove
something.
And tinfoil hats will prevent that.
Yeah, yeah. No, you're like, that's the thing. Like, don't start getting violent, because they'll double it up real quick. They'll double it up real quick. So
I don't think Mike even caught that.
What was it?
I said, and that's what you use the tinfoil hats for.
Oh. I didn't, yeah. I was on a tirade. I was thinking about, come on, guys, like, let's not do stupid shit in a protest, you know? Have your own medical aid. Have your own medical aid. There we go. Yeah, Steve.
Yes.
You're the closest to being a doctor on this podcast.
Yeah, I don't know about being a doctor.
Closest, too.
This is not medical advice.
This is not medical advice, not by Steve.
I plan on Saturday, there's a protest. As this podcast is airing, actually, that I will likely be at, I'll probably be representing free aid, providing free first aid services to anybody who might need them at the protest.
And that's important in my head, because if you're hurt during a protest, and you're hurt during a protest that has gone in a real dark and dangerous situation where the cops have decided they're the Gestapo without sending out a memo to everybody, and you get hurt, the ambulance ain't going to get there anytime soon. So that's why if it's good to have somebody on the side of the protest that is neutral. And what I mean is that if, you know, people... You can have somebody that you know show up to the protest. Just make sure that they know that their entire purpose for being there is to help people if they're injured. Their purpose is to not get involved. There's, like, the Red Cross. As a matter of fact, if to be extra safe, go ahead and put a Red Cross on your shirt with tape or whatever you can do to make clear that you are not, you know...
Yeah.
Cats love cameras, man.
Cats love this camera.
Coconut, what are you doing?
She's posing. She's posing.
I think we have also missed a huge portion. Cameras.
Yes. Thank you, Matt.
Cameras.
Issue two, yeah. Cameras.
Yes. We gotta have cameras at a protest, and a lot of them. I would suggest one camera per person. That's my opinion.
Right.
Preferably backed up or streamed to the internet.
Your cell phones do have cameras.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so use if you've them. Got a cell phone, which pretty much everybody does now, use the video camera. There are apps you can use to stream it live to the internet to have it backed up offsite. So
yeah, you don't want
happen.
Your only copy to be on your phone.
Yeah,
that could get destroyed.
There are multiple methods of
but
doing
BitTorrent
that.
Sync, the New Jersey UCLA Ustream.
Yeah, there's
a bunch of apps out there.
The internet is a great resource, I'm sure. Anybody watching this would probably be able to figure it out. If not, I'm sure...
And here comes Dagger.
That's the third cat. We've got all of them now, right?
No, Baraku
sure.
has
Baraku
been
has been
just
yeah, okay,
two.
Well.
Yeah.
We call this one Dagger because she will stab you.
That cat will stab you. But so, cameras. Yeah.
She's a hired mercenary.
Yes.
And here's a little trick if you're worried about, like... recording everything, which, you know, you should be worried about, or not worried about, but doing your best to record everything you can when you're in a situation like that. If your battery's super low, guess what? Taking pictures uses a lot less battery. Sometimes taking a bunch of pictures in a row, that's enough evidence to show, like, there is a continuation of this action. if something bad happens. So, you know, if you're in a pinch, you can, you know, if you got 10% left, you can take a couple pictures real quick if something bad happens, you know? And that might be enough.
Yeah, if you're planning on going to a protest, charge your battery first.
For sure.
Backup batteries, there's portable batteries that are great, very small. Yep. They last for a while. Yeah, all that stuff. It could really help you out, especially if anything goes down and you need video evidence or something. I know that anytime I've had an interaction with the police and I had a camera on me, they were usually all of a sudden much more polite.
Likewise. Yep. Okay, so there's two people. Steve's had the same situation, I'm sure. Yep, you have a camera
except
on
for, you know, when Matt's, like, blowing me up in front of the cops and shit. Cops are all like, so what are you guys' names? Matt's like, come on, Steve, let's get out of here. I'm like, what?
That was pretty funny. Yeah.
Yeah, don't be talking to the police. And I don't mean, like, if there's a protest going on and the police are on the sidelines. And, you know, what I mean is that when I say don't talk to them, I mean that pretty literally. Don't be flipping the birds of cops. What's that going to do, really? What's that going to do other than piss some guy off who has violent tendencies? Usually. Yeah.
And weapons.
You know, don't be, like, antagonizing the cops in a way. You might be like, oh, well, they said not do anything violent, but I can always flip a bird to the cop. I wouldn't recommend it. Just ignore them. Just because that's not, you know, you're not there to piss those cops off. You're there to show people, including those police, that you are a peaceful human being and you want them to act in a similar fashion. So by sitting there, like, kind of antagonizing them, you're putting it in their head that, oh no, these guys really are bad guys and we do have to stop them, you know?
I would like to see more, like, conversations going on at protests.
Mm-hmm.
I would say, in the case of police, though, I would never recommend talking to the police. It's just a bad idea all around.
Mm-hmm.
So
I think, sad, because any other situation you'd be like, no, you want to talk to people and be like, this is why we're marching out here. But the cops, I would recommend not saying anything, because anything you
for
say
your own
again,
safety, really.
It can be used against you.
Other forms of protest, I definitely think it's good to have as much conversation with people who are interested in the subject. If you've got a group of people out there and they're all willing to talk about the subject and they all know what they're talking about, it's going to get much more. It's going to have it's going to have more of an effect than a bunch of people there just with signs yelling and stopping traffic and pissing people off.
Should it be mentioned if they're wearing all black and they have something black covering their face that they may be a cop? Should that be mentioned?
Watch out for cops.
And I don't think that's a point past paranoia. That's reality.
I've seen it. No,
you know? Yeah, exactly. We all have. Like, you've seen some weird fucking people.
I've
like,
had agent provocateurs try to have me start shit. And I had to repeat over and over, you know, this is peaceful as this is not.
Yeah.
Not setting cars on fire for you.
Yeah, no, you definitely need to watch out for that. It's usually the guy who's recommending violence or something.
So, hey guys, when are we going to overthrow the government?
Yeah. That's exactly who the cop is.
Now, no tinfoil nonsense, anything at all here. Honest to God, every single person sitting at this table has had somebody they don't know said, hey guys, we should overthrow the government. So that's all you need to know. If you think I'm crazy, or you think Steve's crazy, or you think Matt's crazy, every single person sitting at this table has had that happen to him, literally in those words. Yeah.
It's a bunch of feds, man.
Yeah. So always keep that in mind. Yeah.
Yeah. I remember the protest in Escondido. Yeah, there was an agent provocateur there who was going around trying to start shit and walked up to us, trying to get us to, oh, why, you guys are young, why aren't you flipping cars over?
Why aren't you just, you know, putting your back into it to get that old fucking beetle over, you know?
Repeatedly told him it was peaceful and all that, and had no intentions to do anything of the matter. And he followed him down the street, and he ended up with a bunch of cops wearing the same jacket, all standing by our cruiser chatting.
Oh.
Yeah.
yeah, I told this kid to flip over a car and he didn't listen to me. We're moving on. Yeah, I don't know what they're talking about, but it does happen. Like, that's the thing. There's no, you know, paranoia involved here. You can be too paranoid to protest. Don't get me wrong. You can have people to come up to you who are pissed and angry and say some shit that may sound like violent, and they may not be cops. Don't get that in your head either, that everybody who says something off color is all of a sudden a cop. But, you know, if somebody says something...
I think, really, you just don't worry about it.
Yeah,
as long as you're...
I think most voluntarists aren't violent at all anyway.
Exactly.
I mean, you're not going to have...
Right.
Even if the cops were investigating some voluntarist group or something, they're not going to see, like, really having, you know...
Bingo, bango. Yeah. They're going to have a super boring report. Their higher up is going to be the report.
Voluntarists are not violent.
Yeah. I went to a meeting of voluntarists and or talked to voluntarists at a protest.
Yeah.
They said nothing of violence. They said nothing about hurting anyone. In fact, they usually like most people who are new. Winky face, you know, and that's gonna be the email, you know, like it's you know, yeah, as long as you're not a violent person, don't be worried about, you know, people coming in, because it's at least hilarious.
And guess what? Those cops who are undercover, those are people too.
Mm-hmm.
They need to hear the truth just like anybody else does. Yep.
To paraphrase Adam Kokesh, they are also free, beautiful, and independent human beings. You know, like, they also have got everything going on in their life that leads them to their motivating decisions in life, be it bad or good, whether we agree with it or not. That person is still a human being. Yep. To when you start dehumanizing people, that's where you have ugly things happen. That's where you have horribly ugly things happen. Let's look at the bad part of the French Revolution. You had Robespierre being like, well, this person is a tax collector, I think. I'm pretty sure he's a tax collector. You guys don't like him. He looks like he has a lot of money. We should cut his head off. And you get enough people to agree with that, all of a sudden that person loses their head. Like, yeah, don't, you know, be riling people up and trying to do violent things, because it will end bad. Whether you believe it or not, violence is a horrible, horrible thing.
And even when you win, it's kind of cliche, but even when you win, you lose.
Yeah, you stoop down to their level, because they're the ones who are being violent. That's what the protests are about, is because the cops are being violent. So when you start getting violent, you're doing the exact same thing they are and saying that they are different than you. You know, and so don't be doing that, you know. There is plenty of examples in the history of the world. Sadly, there is not more of them, but there are plenty of examples of nonviolent action that has resulted in victories for your average Joe Sixpack and Jane Wine Cooler to live their lives as they want to live their lives, you know.
Yeah. I definitely can't advocate violence in any means, because that's just going to perpetuate exactly what I'm against. So... Yeah.
Do you think there's a certain amount of discretion you need to have when choosing what kind of protest to go to?
I think if you were to ever get any sort of... I'll use Facebook as an example, because I'm not going to go into little details, but I have had an issue happen in the past where I was, you know, put into a group on Facebook that I didn't know who they were, I didn't know what they were about, but when I looked into that group a little bit, they seemed to have some weird tendencies that I didn't agree with, that did not jive with my personality at all. But on Facebook, you can just add somebody into a group if you feel like it. So do keep in mind that, like, if you're being asked to be part of a group, and if you just click that OK button and be like, oh, that kind of sounds like me, You don't know that, because you could have been grouped into something, and before you know it, you're grouped into something, and, you know, some government agencies are going to be like, oh, that guy, you know.
So do you think that protesting would be effective in getting, say, sentient robot sex workers' rights?
Yeah, I think it would. I think if... You know, you had some androids who acknowledged that they were free, independent, and beautiful beings, and they could process their own stuff and realize that they are alive, then yeah, having a protest to free their
You know what? I just realized we're out of time.
God damn it! This was a lot looser. I figured we had time to do robot sex.
Yeah, but man, time really flew by on that one.
We'll get to it one of these days.
One of these days, robot sex episode.
Down on it.
Cheers.
Good night.